Matata, Hakuna, Matata, Hakuna.
It's a problem-free philosophy. Hakuna Matata.
You've worked with Avengers, but this time you assembled a different team of Avengers.
Yes.
For the voices in this movie. I mean, Beyonce, James Earl Jones.
Yes. It really is an embarrassment of riches. Just to get James Earl Jones to be in this completely grounds us and anchors us in the tradition of the original film. And then Beyonce, you have, you know, everybody knows what a wonderful singer and performer she is, but then also great acting and bringing life to this character. We just have first choices all around. It's been a dream cast.
You have to take your place as king.
The big thing was we had to make sure it didn't feel like an animated remake. We had to make sure it felt like a whole different medium. Just like the play is different than the movie, and they both feel like they're their own thing, but connected. We wanted this one to feel like a third way of telling the story. Especially in the beginning, whenever we could, we would get them all together in a room and get them to perform the scenes. Like humans, they weren't acting like animals. They weren't crawling around. But they would perform the scenes on their feet, holding the scripts as like we were doing a theater rehearsal. And if they came up with ideas, we would just try them. And all of that would be recorded. And then I would take that to the editing room, and then we would animate to those performances.
The thing I'm actually more excited about is the fact that you did not only take inspiration from the movie, but also the Julie Taymor play.
That's right.
How did that work out?
Well, the Julie Taymor play, it was interesting how, and it was only a few years after the movie, how much more they delved into the cultural inspiration, the cultural underpinnings of the African, musically, visually. They really embraced and explored further and made more authentic that aspect of the experience. It's very moving to have people who are involved in the stage productions and the old film. All of them share one thing in common, is they care so much about the legacy of it. Even the recording sessions with the singers and the musicians, the orchestra, and with Hans. Hans would wear the same shirt every day. It was a shirt that he had from the old movie. It was amazing that people who have so much going on in their lives and their careers took so much care and effort to make sure that we got this in a way that they were proud of and that lived up to the responsibility to the original.
This is not the first time you worked with Disney for a live action.
Yes.
You did The Jungle Book. Did you feel any kind of evolution?
Well, this one was a much bigger undertaking. And I learned a lot on Jungle Book, and that was a very fulfilling experience, but it was closer to what I was used to. This was, you know, I've never worked in a film that was completely animated. I've always had actors and cameras, and it was all coordinating between all the different departments in real time. Technically, it was much more challenging, and then also as far as how much people were familiar with and cared about this this original property, that gave us an added sense of responsibility as well.
You must take your place. And the circle of life.